morning, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to the graduation ceremony 2021. Please rise. Before I welcome everybody, just a few general notices. Please can I ask you at this moment to kindly switch your cell phones off, and also for the duration of the proceedings, if you could remain in the auditorium, please. Good morning to all our guests here this morning, our honored guests, to everybody that is joining us on our live stream, to our graduates, our and friends. Welcome to the Open Window Institute graduation ceremony for visual communication. Nelson Mandela said, it's always impossible until it is done. And today, and this year, is evidence of that. And today is extra special because this is a celebration of not only your achievements, but also of your resilience, of your dedication, of your perseverance. No one could have predicted what the last year would have held for us, never mind the last few years that you've been studying. But it is through your grit, through your resilience that you are here. But not only just you, as we all know, it takes a village to raise a child. And those guests who are able to join us today via live stream and live, it's because of your support, your input, your love that we are here this morning and are able to celebrate our incredible graduates of 2021. And of course, we have to honor our incredible academia who have guided these incredible individuals through the last couple of years. So this morning, I want to invite you to applaud in a different way. I know this is quite a formal proceeding, I want you to applaud like you've never applauded before, because you've just gone through a grueling number of years to be here, and probably one of the most traumatic years in history. We are actually making history right now. You are graduating having lived through a pandemic, which is unheard of in the last few generations. So guests, I want to applaud you to applaud like you've never applauded before, because right here we are making history, and they are about to enter the greatest adventure yet. So without further ado, I'd like to introduce you to Dr. Jane Crawshaw Hall Robertson, who is our head of academics.
Management, I would like to welcome everyone here, both online and here, to the graduation of the class of 2020, a day where the dedication of our students to achieve the goals set out are recognized in a formal ceremony. For us all to be sitting here today is also, I'm quite sure, special for our graduates, as they are here, sitting alongside their peers in person. Something that this group of graduates has not been able to do for many months. So the fact that we can be here together on this day is also quite significant. I would like to extend a particularly warm welcome to our graduates who have worked incredibly hard. Our graduates have invested many hours of work, made many sacrifices. and have shown wonderful dedication to be here today. It is also worth mentioning that today's graduates have not been on this journey alone, but so have those that form part of their support structures, so parents, sponsors, family, and friends. I would also like to welcome both our academic and non-academic staff members from the Open Window, who are attending both in person and online. This day is also a very special day for Open Window staff members who have supported our students to become graduates, their lecturers, student advisors, student supporters, the administrators, and all those involved in the education experience at the Open Window. So this celebration represents great pride for our institution, and watching our graduates walk in just now was really something quite emotional for all of us. So my address to all of you on this day comes on the back of a new experience of my own and a considered outlook that I have realized on the back of that experience. I recently welcomed a little boy into this world. In fact, I'm still on maternity leave, but the celebration is not something I would like to miss. And something that I've always known, but now have first-hand experience of, is that parents and guardians, and those that have a responsibility in guiding and supporting young people to become the best possible versions of themselves, will go to great lengths to make the dreams of their loved ones a reality where possible. Therefore, I would like to congratulate you, parents, guardians, sponsors, friends, for doing just that. I believe you have given our graduates a wonderful start to what I am sure will be an adventurous, courageous, and creative career in the future. Today we celebrate our graduates who have successfully completed their creative education and who we can confidently say have built up determination and resilience and who have gained cultural and societal awareness throughout their academic careers. We feel confident that our graduates will be starting their careers with awareness, empathy, and appreciation of difference and diversity. I could speak for hours about the value of a creative education, and I'm not going to, but our current global economy prioritizes those that are knowledgeable, imaginative, and innovative. And a case in point would be the recent pandemic and the needs of the economic workforce to cope with fast-paced changes that occurred as a result. Those in the workplace that are creative and innovative have managed to offer solutions to difficult, time-sensitive requirements. So to embark on a creative career is to embrace lifelong learning about concepts, strategies, and ideas, in addition to the skills that are required in expressing them. Some may question what the value is in studying within the creative arts, where there is a strong focus conceptual development that is in direct dialogue with developing talent and skill. To have the ability to present great concepts or ideas takes immense effort and can ultimately exercise great impact on our communities and general surroundings. Concepts, theories, and ideas, after all, have the ability to change the world. My favorite example of a powerful idea that changed our world is democracy. So democracy started off as an idea developed out of critical thought about what worked and what didn't in our society. Understanding that there was a better way of organizing our society, it was mostly creatives that spread the popular message about the potentials of what a democratic society could offer, whether through film, art, design, music, the list goes on. At the Open Window, we value, above all, the development of the skill to take provocative thoughts, ideas, and critical concepts to further evolve these, and finally, to express them through means of creative expression in a way that makes them accessible to all, while still provoking a response. So for this group of graduates, their final year was rocked by the start of a global pandemic, which still impacts how we approach events today. This graduation being one of them. And which I'm quite certain will impact all events whether directly or indirectly. This group of graduates overcame those hardships encountered in the first extremely chaotic year of the pandemic. Their sitting here as graduates is a testament to their ability, not only in their creative skills, but more so in their ability to adapt, to plan, to reorganize and re-strategize, to understand a changing world and a changing work dynamic, and to do this quickly, efficiently, and with tenacity and dedication. So in celebrating these graduates, and without further hesitation, I would like to officially open this graduation ceremony. We will be announcing top student awards, both for the qualification as well as for subjects, during the conferring and awarding of qualifications. The criteria for top student achievements are as follows. To achieve the top student award in a certificate, the candidate must have completed the full course within 1 year. The top certificate student will receive a 50,000 rand bursary towards their first year degree studies at the open window. To achieve the top student award for the degree, the candidate must have completed a minimum of 120 credits per year for 3 consecutive years. The top degree student receives a 50,000 rand bursary towards their honours degree at the open window. And then to achieve the top student award for the honours degree, the candidate must have completed a minimum of 120 credits within a single year. The top honours student will receive a 3,000 rand book voucher from the exclusive course. And so, by the power vested in me by the open window, I declare all those who I acknowledged by name during this graduation ceremony to have their degrees conferred and their qualifications awarded.
I would now like to welcome our alumni speaker, Christy Spiller.
Staff, parents, friends, family, and most importantly, class of 2020 graduates. My name is Christy Sivrat, and it is with great pleasure that I get to return to this inspiring campus and commemorate this incredibly special occasion with you all. Today marks the moment when you can stand tall, proud of all you have achieved, looking towards a bright future. Today you can reflect on all that has brought you to this moment, the all-nighters, the puzzling briefs, the intense lectures in which you could hardly keep your eyes open. I encourage you to look back on your first year self. You had the passion and motivation to end up where you are now. The younger you who loved the thought of creatively solving problems in a way that brings about change and improvement to the society in which we find ourselves. If I could, I would go back and thank my 18-year-old self for deciding to take a chance and walk into this field of design, which, quite honestly, I knew very little about. Our lives are made up of the small day-to-day decisions. Some quite insignificant, while others are truly life-altering. I hope you look back in great admiration at how far you have come, and now entering this exciting and inspiring industry. Class of 2020, you truly possess a determination like perspective to keep going and creating, regardless of the hardships that come your way. 2020 brought about numerous uncertainties and hindrances. However, you were all able to overcome those, and for that I applaud you. From experience, leaving Open Window with a well-earned degree is in itself a great achievement, but doing so without being able to step foot on campus or sit across from a lecturer or group project teammate is highly admirable. You all hold a unique story and perspective of how to be persistent and resourceful when facing quite literally a worldwide lockdown. When all stood still for a moment, you were able to pick yourselves up and continue. What a beautiful and inspiring picture of what the field of design has to look forward to. As you walk into this new phase of your life, I implore you to hold fast to these traits and make them known wherever you find yourselves. Continue to be diligent, self-motivated, front-footed, encouraged, kind, empathetic, persistent, and resourceful. At times, you might feel overwhelmed, or even like you don't know how to complete the task that you've been entrusted with. But I would like to encourage you by saying that that is okay. Just think about it this way. For every day that you continue, you know more than you did the day before. Slowly but surely, you will build up a portfolio and a reputation. I have no doubt that I am surrounded by incredibly capable and talented graduates who will make a name for themselves, whether it be in communication design, photography, or illustration. The great thing about our industry is that it has come an incredibly long way and evolved into something quite extraordinary. There is still so much to learn, to discover, to question, and to solve. Don't ever think that what you have to offer is not quite as good or as significant as somebody else. You have a thought process and a perspective and an approach like no other. So I encourage you to walk this new path confidently, humbly, and willing to work hard, make mistakes, and create something incomparable. You are walking into a field that has the power to bring about change. Never forget that. Whether you walk into a job alongside a well-established team or decide to forge your own way, know that you leave this campus with an immensely admirable and powerful tool belt. Graduating with a degree from Open Window already puts you in a highly desired position, simply because you have been well equipped to identify problems and tackle them in a unique, dynamic, and resourceful way. And the industry you are walking into knows that. I hope that you all look back at your time on this campus with admiration. Yes, it has been incredibly challenging at times, but you were all privileged enough to have devout lecturers and resources alongside you every step of the way. I am forever grateful for my time on this campus. I received my degree in visual communication design and later returned to complete my honors degree while working in a design studio that I co-founded. I look back in admiration at my time where I've been equipped, guided, and encouraged to achieve during my time at Open Window. Thanks to my incredible lecturers in my honors year, I was able to occupy public spaces in the city of Johannesburg, make connections with people who I would never otherwise have had the opportunity to meet, learn and record inspiring stories, and orchestrate powerful public activations, all for the purpose of making a difference through design. One thing I can tell you is that design is everywhere, which basically means that by applying yourselves, you should never be without a job. That seems like a bold statement, I know, but I truly believe that what you have to offer this world will never not be needed. Continue to apply yourselves and never stop learning. The fun is just beginning. As I'm sure you will agree, we do not design for the mere sake of designing, but rather to expose faults, highlight communication, bring relief, and encourage action. I remember finishing school and telling people I wanted to study visual communication design, and then looking at me with confusion and, strangely enough, pity. Well, the joke's on him, as I'm sure you would agree. This industry in which you have chosen to make your mark is an incredibly beautiful one, albeit daunting, ever-growing, and evolving, but what other industry could give you the joy and satisfaction that the ever-open world of design does? As creators, we have a responsibility to not just view things the way they are, but to change and challenge the norm and ask questions. We should constantly be asking ourselves, could this be better, and how? This process definitely is not an easy one, but is what makes our work impactful and necessary. Something I encourage you all to do is to work towards surrounding yourselves with a strategic community of people who are passionate and experienced in their field of interest. Whether they have advice to offer you based on the industry you are walking into or not, learning from others, gaining perspective, and adding to your tool belt is something I encourage you to never neglect, but continually work on. I'd love to tell you that the hard part is over, and that from here on out it will be smooth sailing. That you will never procrastinate again. You know, telling yourself that next year we must definitely start in week one, but find yourself in week 8, pulling a few all-nighters and thinking there's no way you'll get this done. Well, once again, look at where you are now. You made it. And while the working world may not be easier than what you have just walked through, I can assure you that it is exciting, stretching, energizing, motivating, and a truly thrilling place to be. The opportunities are endless. All you have to do is be willing to ask the right questions. I hope that you feel encouraged and truly ready to take on this new, challenging adventure. You don't have to be great to start, but you do have to start to be great. I encourage you to never doubt your capabilities, as well as to not be afraid to ask questions. The world is not out to see you fail, but is awaiting the extraordinary creations you will bring to life. 2020 graduates, I salute you for all you have achieved, and along with your lecturers, family, and friends, look forward to seeing where this exciting adventure takes you. So as you say farewell to this campus and hello to the exciting unknown, all I have left to say is, go knock their socks off.
Nika Boshoff. And you can smile, because I can see your smile through your mouth. Tegan Clark. In absentia, Michelle Dexter. Angelo Swan. Angelique Randall. Iman Mutani. Chanel Slevet. Dean Godfrey Sutherland. Visual communication design with a single major in illustration. Kaya Herson. Kaya Herson also has a best achievement in visual communication. So you can give a round of applause. Heather Jenkins. Krizan van der Merwe. In visual communication design with a single major in photography. Jason Knell. Danielle Kritzinger. Michaela Lannefeld. Nicole Nell. Carla Schwartz. You will now be doing a Bachelor of Arts in Visual Communication Design with a double major in Illustration and Photography. Jamari Dupriya. Savannah Sinden. Bachelor of Arts in Visual Communication Design with a double major in Communication Design and Emotion Design. Melissa Fisser. Bachelor of Arts in Visual Communication Design with a double major in Communication Design and Illustration. Karabo Mabena. Adrian Reed. Please will you give our group one and class of 2020 one more round of applause. Because we'd like our next group to enter after the showreel. So we'll give you a moment. You can also watch the beginning of the showreel as it comes to a close, if you could kindly make your way through the exit. 2021 at the Open Window. Today we are celebrating the class of 2020. Before we begin with the rest of the ceremony, please will you kindly switch your cell phones either off or on silent, and please will you also remain in the auditorium for the duration of the ceremony. To everybody who's on our live stream, welcome to you as well. Before I begin, we begin with the rest of the graduation. We just want to take this time to honor our graduates. Nelson Mandela said, it's always impossible until it is done. And a day like today is testament of that. Nobody could have predicted what 2020 would have held for you, never mind the last few years that you've been studying at the Open Window. But it is because of your resilience, determination, perseverance, hard work that you are here today. And this is a special celebration. So friends, family, guests, I want to invite you to applaud these graduates this morning because they have done the seemingly impossible under the most unpredictable of circumstances. So today we celebrate you, and we also celebrate you, family, friends, because we all know that it takes a village to raise a child. And it's because of your support, your love, that your incredible kids are here today. And of course, our amazing faculty, our academia, who have guided and supported these graduations over the last 3 and 4 years. We are going to begin with the conferring of the Bachelor of Arts in Visual Communication Design with a double major in Communication Design and Illustration. As they are getting ready, I'm just going to go through the remainder of the program with you. Once we have conferred the entire group qualifications, Dr. Jane Crochet Paul Robertson will be closing the ceremony. We will then rise for the national anthem, and everybody will be asked to exit the Saxovina. We'd like to kindly ask you to not spend time on the campus because we can only accommodate a certain number of people due to COVID regulations. So you're more than welcome to take any additional photographs, but kindly please social distance yourself and make your way to the parking area at your earliest convenience. Bachelor of Arts in Visual Communication Design with a double major in Communication Design and Illustration. Chris Jan Delport. Graduating cum laude and receiving Best Achievement in Illustration, 75%, Best Achievement in BA in Visual Communication, 76%, and will also be getting a trophy this morning, so give him an additional round. Jansen van Rensburg. Marik is also receiving Best Achievement in Communication Design. Kaylin Lowe. Jade Rawson. Edith Smith, Nadia van Staden, Tanya Vermaak, Jessica Zahn, Leandre De Vos, we will now be conferring the Bachelor of Arts in Visual Communication Design with a double major in Communication Design and Photography. Abigail Bowles, Cleopatra Sophia Fasidilis. Anushka Golshah, Nicole van der Kerk, Nicole is also graduate cum laude with best achievement in a Bachelor of Arts in Visual Communication. Bachelor of Arts Honors in Visual Communication with specialization in Visual Communication Design. Anne Sprink, James Sellers. Jane is also receiving the award for Best Achievement in the BA Honours in Visual Communication. Yeah. Mia Kun. Eileen Murray. Jack Singer. Giovanna Stevens. Carla van der Waal. Bachelor of Arts in Visual Communication Design with a single major in Communication Design, Nicole Poncancelos for Communication Design and Illustration. One more round of applause for our class of 2020. I would now like to invite Dr. Jane Crawshaw Paul Robertson, Head of Academics, to close our ceremony.
So in officially closing the ceremony, I would like to once again give a huge congratulations to all of our graduates. And I would like to formally declare this ceremony closed.
Please rise for the national anthem. Thank you. And now you can officially go and party.